हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, विल स्टार्ट इन कपल ऑफ मिनट्स. ओके, विल वेट फॉर अ फ्यू मोर टू ज्वाइन एंड देन विल स्टार्ट. एम आई ऑडिबल? कैन यू हियर मी कौशल, मधुरा, शेफालिका, निखिल?
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
Yes, sir, yes,
Okay,
sir.
all right. Okay, all right. Okay, let's wait for a couple of minutes for a few more to join and then we can start, guys, okay?
Okay, sir, no problem.
Okay. Okay. Afternoon, guys. It's almost around evening. So, how many of you? So the results came out. You know, this has become a trend now with UPSC. Whether it is prelims or mains or the final results, the results are usually coming on Fridays. So a lot of people had an idea that the results are going to come. Okay. So any of you have, you know, had appeared and, you know, cleared the exam? Anyone, guys? Anyone who cleared the prelims this time? You can please respond.
No, sir. No, sir.
No, no. Okay. Anyone, guys? Anyone?
My attempt is for 2022, sir.
Okay. 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 Good. Fine. Theek hai. So you must have seen this year's paper, guys. Before we start, you know, with our anthropology stuff, just some something regarding this year's paper. So you must have seen this year's paper. You know, it was really so UPSC. You know, we you know, one of my teachers used to say, UPSC is the full form is, you know, Unpredictable Public Service Commission. Extremely unpredictable. First of all, you know, sports questions. So sports questions, you know, no one used to study earlier. You know, we used to tell our students. I have myself been told, and I have told many students, you know, that these boys, you know, like many of us, many of the boys who you know, even girls are interested, but you know, the boys usually this, you know, opening the newspaper from, you know, the last pages. We open the newspaper from the last pages, you know why? You know, because we start with the sports news. Let's, you know, first see what happens sports everywhere, and then, you know, we can go and read other stuff. But that really, you know, I mean, and we used to say that for UPSC, you know, you should not be doing that. Sports news is of no use. They don't ask about who, you know, won which match, and awards, authors and writers. These things used to be there in SSC and stuff, you know, but for UPSC, these things, you know, they never asked for many, many years. And that had become a trend. And so, you know, we never prepared any sports stuff, but this time they asked questions even from the sports. So very unpredictable. One, you know, big surprise that is coming up every year nowadays. Any one of you who is, you know, thinks that his maths or reasoning is not very strong, anyone? You can say yes or no. You can give your name. Anyone who feels
that I think that lies in the between.
Sorry?
It's not that good.
Yeah, it's not that good. Okay. Yeah. So, you know, they had introduced this CSAT thing, you know, saying that this is something very, you know, which everyone, it's like qualifying paper, you have to get 33% marks. And, but, you know, from 2017 onwards, the level of this paper has been going up. So some surprises that I came across yesterday, one of my friends who had written mains 4 times and another a student of mine, he was a student of mine who I, you know, whom I had taught anthropology. So he had you know, appeared for interview last year. So these guys who, you know, who have written, one guy written mains, you know, 4 times out of his 5 earlier attempts, written mains 4 times. And another guy who had appeared, it was his second attempt, and he had appeared in his, you know, interview last year. He could not make it, but he had appeared in the interview. These two guys flunked in prelims. They failed in prelims. And what did they fail in? They failed in CSAT. So CSAT is not something, you know, that we can really ignore now. And anyone who feels that, you know, maths and reasoning is okay, or not that great, you have to really practice CSAT. And CSAT is not simply, it's not maths. If you look at the question paper, it's not math anymore. The questions that they ask, you do not solve those questions by using mathematical formulae or, you know, using mathematical short tricks. They are basically, you know, aptitude questions. Questions wherein, you know, no math formula may come in useful. You know, they would ask regarding, say, the questions, you know, direction test that you move these many kilometers, you turn north, left, south, those things are there. But there are a lot of other questions also where you will have to use your logic rather than mathematical calculations. So questions seem to be very easy, not very difficult at times. But the thing is that when, you know, attempting that them in that, you know, time bound manner of, say, 2 hours, if you do not have good practice, you may find it difficult. So please do not ignore, you know, this CSAT paper. Lot of great, you know, very, very good students. So this guy who has written mains, you know, 4 times, and his brother is already an IPS officer. He's a SP of Patna Rural. His brother is SP of Patna Rural in Bihar. So such good students who have such good guidance, who have been, you know, guided by a brother who is already an, you know, IPS, and even they are flunking in CSAT. So it's very, very painful. And please do not ignore CSAT at all. So all that said and done, let's start our session. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. So just a second. Okay. All right, I'll start sharing my screen. Let me see. Khushbu is raising a hand. Let me see what she's saying. Yes, Khushbu. I did not. Okay, I didn't give only this time. So, Kaushal, you had given earlier also. Earlier, I mean, in previous years, had you appeared, Kaushal?
Sir, actually, it will be my first attempt in 2022.
Okay,
I'm currently working in SEBI.
Working in SEBI, Securities Exchange Board of.
Yes, I'm an officer there.
Oh, awesome. So we are talking to a government officer already, you know, who is aiming to be another government officer. So you're already working in SEBI. Nice. Very good.
Thank you.
Okay. Khushbu, not good in CSAT. Yes, Khushbu. So please do not ignore, you know, I have myself failed in CSAT once. And that year, the paper was so tough that people were saying that, you know, the cutoff may go below 90. The cutoff eventually ended up to be around 90, and I had scored 120 plus in paper one in that year, but I had failed in CSAT. So that's why, you know, CSAT, I can relate to the students who failed in CSAT, and that's why I will tell everyone, please do not ignore CSAT. It's just 33% qualifying stuff, but it is no more that easy, it seems, in the last couple of years when some good students are failing in CSAT. Maybe they are ignoring it totally, not paying attention to it, but please be careful. Maybe, you know, you gotta, you know, devote maybe 1 hour a week, 2 hours a week for doing CSAT. But please do it. Okay. So now, without any further delay, let's start. You guys cannot see my screen, right? But can you see me? Nikhil, Madhura, Anjali, can you see me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You can see me. Okay, fine. So I'll share my screen now. Okay. Is the screen visible, guys? You two can score 300. No, it's not. I have not shared it. Wait. I have.
Sir, to... आपसे पूछना था.
हाँ, पूछो.
सर, मैं पहले बैंक में काम करता था पिछले डेढ़ साल से. बैंक की जॉब छोड़कर अभी मैं यूपीएससी के प्रिपरेशन के लिए आया हूँ. तो मुझे सीसेट लगाना जरूरी है क्या? सीसेट के क्लासेस.
No, since you are in maths, it is common sense that your maths will be very good. Your maths and reasoning will be good. But I'll still say, you know, what you do is you just take last year's paper. So this year, the prelims result is Karnikla. Take that question paper just once, you know, that will clear your doubt and everything for the entire preparation time. Just take that paper, tell your family members that do not disturb me for 2 hours. And, you know, take this question paper and take a printout of it. Take a printout of it and staple it like a question paper. Yeah, tell me.
Okay, family साथ में नहीं रहती है, मैं अकेला ही रहता हूँ.
Okay, fine. So you just take a printout of it and staple it like a proper question paper. You know what happens? You know, solving it from the screen and actually, flipping through the pages. That is a different experience altogether. And flipping through the pages is very important to get used to that, because you know in many exams what happens is, you know, that there are several sections. So a section of math, that is over. Section of English, that is over. Section of reasoning, like that, right? But in UPSC, yes, it's not like that. They're all mixed up. So, you know, five English questions in between that, two maths, and then two English, two maths, it's mixed up. So, you know, suddenly if you're running out of time and you want to solve only maths, what you will do is you'll quickly flip the question paper and look for, you know, where is the maths? Where is the maths? Yes. So this, you need to experience that. Okay. So that's why take the question paper, print out, staple it like a question paper for 2 hours, close the room, set a timer, sit like a proper exam condition test. Give that last year ka paper. If you are comfortably clearing the CSAT, no issues. Perfect. Just go ahead. Okay. Because the questions are a little different than the banking. You know, banking mein, if you have practiced the short tricks of, say, percentage, ratio, simple interest, compound interest, this, that, you know, that will work. But those sums are not coming here. they're not asking those sums, right? They're not asking sums where you can use formula and short tricks. Mostly a lot of logical stuff is there. And the comprehension part is, trust me, I'm proud of my English. My English is quite good. My communication is good. I have been a good student of English throughout my schooling career. You know, I was favorite of the English teacher, and all my friends used to fight who will sit behind me on the English exam day, you know, so that they can copy. So I really, I'm very happy with the standard of my English, but still, I have done pathetically in UPSC comprehension at times. Why? Because the questions are not very straightforward. They give you I heard that this time they had given some, sections from Plato's Republic, some philosophical paragraph. And after that, the question will ask, which is the most logical inference? And there are four options, and all four might seem to be logical. So it's not about being good in English or math. UPSC CSAT paper is turning out to be something else. Some of you might still find it very easy, but we all are not, we are all, not all equal. So I will tell everyone who has not had a look at the CSAT paper last 2 years, please try to solve it in 2 hours condition. And that itself will tell you whether you need to work on it or not. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
All right. Well, your name, please.
Sir, Nikhil Durgam.
Okay, Nikhil, can you see my screen now? Can my screen be seen now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, it can be seen. Fine. Let's take it here. Okay. All right. So first of all, I would like to tell you that, congrats, guys, because first of all, you are here in this call, which itself means that you have decided, or maybe, you are on the way of deciding your optional as anthropology. So that actually solves some of the problem, because for people who start preparing for UPSC, not just for the beginners, even for those who have, appeared for several years, even they sometimes think, am I doing good with this optional? Should I change my optional? Kya karun? Optional is a headache. So if this question remains even for many people, even after 2-3 years of preparation, or, appearing 2-3 times still, they feel that they're not happy with the optional and all those things happen. So this optional deciding is a big year headache. Okay? So since you have not decided, which means you have crossed at least one of the hurdles. This exam is full of hurdles. At least one of the hurdles is crossed now that you have decided upon an optional. So at least one hurdle is over. Now the thing is that how to begin well, and how to make the most of this optional. This optional gives amazing opportunity to score well. So you would be knowing, I myself came to know, a little later, not on the exam day itself. On the result day, I did not know that last year rank one, Subham Kumar was also anthropology optional. But this has been a trend. Akshat Jain rank two, Anudeep Dhrushetty rank one, Sachin Gupta rank three. There was another guy who was rank four. So the toppers, rank 1, 2, 3, 4 have been there in anthropology for quite some time. But even if you give that away, keep that inside. If you check the top 100 ranks, a lot of students from anthropology. Why? Because definitely, no subject is like, a cakewalk as, okay. Just 1 second, guys. So, can you hear me again? Kaushal? Audible? Am I audible, Kaushal?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. So as I was saying that no optional is like, you know, a cakewalk that, okay, anthropology everyone is taking, let me take anthropology and score 300. No, that doesn't happen. You just take an optional and score a 300, that doesn't happen. Obviously UPSC will not, you know, do this injustice, you know, as to keep one optional very easy or stuff like that. But then why so many people take anthropology? There is definitely something in this optional that gives you ample opportunity of scoring really well. You know, some of them are, you know, I had made a video on that also, that why anthropology is a good option. You know, there are so many things like the diagrams, examples and stuff, that opportunity that it gives you to make diagrams, to give unique examples, to give unique case studies. I don't think any other optional gives. Plus, no other optional can be revised. You know, nowadays you see, if you see the routine of the exam, last 4 or 5 years they're doing it before the optional exam. Before the optional exam, they are giving 5 days gap. So you have SA done, GS1, 2 done, GS3, 4 done, you know, English and language paper done, and now the last paper left is optional, and the exam gives there's a 5 days break. There's 5 or 6 days gap, and then the final exam happens of optional. 5, 6 days gap before optional. So that is an awesome time period, and there is no other optional that can be revised in that 5, 6 days totally, apart from, you know, anthropology. Okay, someone has asked a question. Share how to approach physical anthropology in answer writing, sir, like Mendel's law and Hardy-Weinberg. ठीक है, ग्रेट, नो इश्यूज, वील टॉक अबाउट दैट एज वेल. ओके, सो यू हैव सेलेक्टेड यू नो एंथ्रोपोलॉजी, दैट इज अ गुड थिंग इन इटसेल्फ. नाउ लेट्स सी हाउ टू मैक्सिमाइज योर स्कोर इन एंथ्रोपोलॉजी. सो यू टू कैन स्कोर हाउ मच? 300+ इन एंथ्रोपोलॉजी. हाउ? लेट्स सी. सो दिस वीडियो बेसिकली इज अबाउट फाइव बूस्टर्स, boosters to boost your anthropology marks. So, you know, with some dedicated effort, you may be able to, you know, have a preparation of 240 to 50 marks. Just a preparation you'll have. But then how to push it beyond 300? You know, because that is what makes the difference. I know one UPSC topper, Lakshmi Nagappan. You know, she got All India rank 45 or 46, she got a few years ago. She had average kind of scores in, you know, SA, GS1, 2, 3, 4, but she scored 360 plus in anthropology. 360 plus in anthropology, and that, you know, just propelled her in the top 50. So 300 plus is very important if you want to get a very good score, a very good rank. But I'm talking about boosters. Why do I have this image here? What this image has to, you know, got to do with boosters. What is this first place in the first? क्या है, क्या ये? What is this in the first place? What is it, guys? This thing? I mean, you should be aware, follow current affairs. What is this? Anyone? No one is aware. What is this? PSLV. No, it is actually not PSLV. It's actually GSLV. Okay, PSLV नहीं है ये, this is GSLV. What is the difference PSLV GSLV? You can, you know, because, you know, I will have to go to the chat every time, so if you guys speak out, that will be better. You know, I will be able to hear, and you know, we can have a discussion also. Difference between PSLV and GSLV, just one short difference. Okay, fine, let it be. So PSLV basically, you know, polar satellite launch vehicle. It is used for lesser loads, smaller loads, and GSLV is basically, it's GSLV is used for heavier loads, and the latest being the GSLV Mark 3. So latest being GSLV Mark 3. So basically, this was GSLV Mark 3 ka image, and GSLV Mark 3 G GSLV Mark 3 is India's rocket, you know, that can take 5,000 kg plus weight of satellites into the space. Usually, you know, for this such a heavy satellite, we use French, you know, rockets. But if we can use our own rocket, it will be great. So this rocket, how does it go that far? How does it carry that much weight? It is because of what you see in on, you know, on the sides. This one, and there are two more. These are called strap-on boosters. These are called strap-on boosters. These strap-on boosters carry extra fuel and they boost the movement of this rocket. So that is this class. That is what this class is about. This rocket has got four boosters, but we will talk about five boosters. Okay. First one, diagrams and maps. So diagrams and maps. Yes. Very logical, you know, very, very common sense, you know, that if you make diagrams and maps, you get good marks. But it's not, you know, you have to understand basically why. So your exam is over. Every, you know, the answer sheets are gone for checking. And suppose, for example, a professor has to check 50 copies a day. He's checking 50 copies a day. You must be knowing anthropology is very popular. One of the reasons for that is syllabus seems to be quite short compared to many subjects. Why it is so? It is because very few books. Someone is asking something. Okay. My sound, I mean, are you guys getting echo on my sound? Anjali, is there echo? Or can you hear me fine? Nikhil, can you hear me fine, or is there echo? Guys, please respond. Can you guys hear me, or is there echo? I can hear you fine. Okay, Anjali has. Okay, so I believe if there is echo, try to, you know, can you leave and rejoin if you see that works? Because there should not be echo. Okay, so you know, there are very few books. If you compare with a lot of subjects, you know, I give this example again and again. For example, if I have a history optional, in history optional, you know, modern India. So for modern India, which books you guys read? Madhura, modern India, which book? For history, or Shefalika, which book? You guys can, you know, speak on in the video. Which book do we use mostly for modern India?
Sonali Bansal.
Sonali Bansal for modern India. I'm really
Spectrum, sir.
Spectrum usually, yeah. Sonali Bansal may be a good book, but I am hearing for the first time. Maybe it is a very good book, but I hear for the first time. So yeah, Spectrum is a book that is very, very popular for modern India. Yeah. You know, but few years ago, the more popular book was Bipan Chandra. Bipan Chandra was more powerful, more popular. So very popular. Now, if I'm history optional, I start with Bipan Chandra. I read it and I find it. Yeah. Good. Nice. Good book. My friend says, yaar, what are you doing? You're reading Bipan Chandra. It's outdated. Read Spectrum. It is exam oriented. So I read Spectrum. I find, yes, it is much more better, you know, much more exam oriented. Then my friend says, another friend comes and says, man, you're using reading Spectrum. Spectrum is a book that is read by GS guys. You know, it is read for history GS. You are a history optional guy. How can you read, you know, Spectrum? Read Shekhar Bandopadhyay, Plassey II Partition. And I read Plassey II Partition. I find out, yes, man, he is right. It is much more, you know, a lot of criticism and critical. It is critical of everything. Proper critical evaluation of a lot of things which are not there in other books. So I feel up, kya karu main, what should I do? So I end up reading so many books. That happens if I am a history optional student, and happens in many other optional subjects. Anthropology optional doesn't have too many books, very few books that are recommended. For example, for archaeology part, most of the students will read, you know, D.K. Bhattacharya. For the anthropological theories part, you know, Upadhyay and Pandey. So maybe at the max, two books are recommended for a part. You can do with only one book. Because of this, what happens? Most of the students end up reading the same books. सो नाउ दिस प्रोफेसर इज चेकिंग 50 कॉपीज एंड कॉपी आफ्टर कॉपी कॉपी आफ्टर कॉपी ही इज सीइंग द सिमिलर आंसर्स, ही इज सीइंग द सेम पॉइंट्स, ही इज सीइंग द सेम एग्जांपल्स. एंड फॉर एग्जांपल दिस गाय हैज हैड अ फाइट विद हिज वाइफ. इन द मॉर्निंग हिज वाइफ यू नो सेड दैट लेट्स गो आउट इन द मार्केट एंड ही सेज नो नो आई हैव 50 कॉपीज टू चेक. एंड द वाइफ फाइट्स दैट यू नो यू ऑलवेज हैव दिस, यू नेवर टेक मी आउट, ब्ला ब्ला ब्ला, दोस थिंग्स स्टार्ट, यू नो माई लाइफ हैज बीन रुइंड विथ यू एंड ऑल दोस थिंग्स. एंड दिस प्रोफेसर इज वेरी अपसेट एंड ही सिट्स विद द कॉपीज एंड ही फाइंड्स ऑल स्टूडेंट्स राइटिंग द सेम थिंग. वॉट डू यू थिंक विल बी द आउटकम? What will the outcome, guys? You're saying you're replying, but your voice is very low. Can you just you know, maybe increase your volume, please? Yeah, it's yeah. What will be the outcome? Kya hoga outcome? The outcome will be that you know he will give average marks, and you must be aware of this that suppose I'm not happy with my marks, I do an RTI. RTI for what? I want a copy of my answer sheet. Do you think UPSC will give you a copy of an answer sheet? Do you think UPSC gives a copy of answer sheet? UPSC does not give you a copy of answer sheets. Why? There was a Supreme Court case. And the Supreme Court has allowed UPSC not to share answer sheet copies because UPSC Supreme Court said that sharing copies of answer sheet delays the process and UPSC will become like other state exams where the exam will be delayed. So UPSC does not share a copy of your answer sheet. So this teacher checking 50 copies, finding everyone's answer to be same, having fought with his wife, very upset, gives you 4444455555 in all the answers. And you can't even get an answer sheet copy to check, you know, what happened. This is out of control. Yes, I know. Out of your control. But what you can do is you have to make your answer sheet so good that when the guy looks at your, you know, answer sheet, he forgets his wife. Man, what an answer sheet. Such beautiful diagrams, examples. Wow, let me read this nicely. And he keeps, you know, flips through your pages, reads your answers nicely. He finds good diagrams and maps and stuff. Different from others, and you will get marks also that are different from others. So that's why diagrams and maps are important in GS also, but in anthropology also extremely important. But some diagrams and maps, for example, you know, a question comes regarding pastoralism or pastoral tribes. So someone will write about the pastoral tribes. What are pastoral tribes? Pastoral tribes are tribes. What are pastoral tribes, guys? Anyone? Pastoral tribes? What is the meaning of pastoral? I mean, feel someone is trying to answer, but still no one is answering. Please be involved, you know, I mean, try to enjoy it. So,
organizing tribe, sir. Organized tribes or specialized organized tribe for usually they pasturing, wandering here and there.
Yes, you know, they live by you know, rearing animals.
Yes,
you know, yeah, so pastoral tribes are those. So who is this, your name please?
Nikhil sir. Nikhil Durga.
Okay Nikhil, can you do you know name of any pastoral tribes, any pastoral tribes of India,
sir? Like Chhattisgarh, sorry.
Any names that you know you will find pastoral tribes everywhere, but some popular ones are Bakarwal and Gaddis. Bakarwals, as the name says, you know, they rear goats. Gaddis, they rear cattle and sheep. Bakarwals, Gaddis. You have Todas in south, you know, Nilgiris in Kerala and
sir,
Tamil
Munda,
Nadu Junction.
Munda tribes, sir. Munda.
Oh, no. Mundas are not pastoral. Mundas are agricultural tribes. They are very good in agriculture. You know, they have good, because they live in flat lands and they do a lot of agriculture and stuff. But these Bakrawals, Gaddis, Todas and all, so Todas depend mostly on buffalo, okay?
Sir, Maldhari tribe of Gujarat.
Maldhari, yes, Maldhari tribe in Gujarat. ओके नाउ नाउ हु इज दिस, किसने आंसर दिया ये, हु गेव दिस आंसर?
कृतिका
ओके ओके कृतिका, कृतिका नाउ टेल मी, मालधारीज व्हाट एनिमल डू दे रियर?
सो इट्स अ बफेलो आई थिंक.
मालधारीज डू यू नो रियर सेवरल एनिमल्स बट दे हैड बिकम सडनली इंपॉर्टेंट इन यूपीएससी फॉर अ यूनिक एनिमल.
So it's a wild buffalo, but I'm forgetting the name right now.
It's actually a camel. You know, in Gujarat, you know, they rear a unique type of camel that's called the Kharai camel.
Kharai camel.
Yes. Yeah, this Kharai camel, you know, they swim into the water. Yes. They go on
for
some islands and
spend... they can swim.
Yeah.
Sir, recently in the news also, because they travel from Gujarat to Chhattisgarh, sir, during COVID.
Okay. So yes, very good. You are keeping a track of this, you know, current affairs. Awesome. Very nice.
Yes,
do make note of these. You know, these will come in handy somewhere in some answer.
Yes.
So this Kharai camel is unique. You know, they swim in water. They go to some islands, you know, where there is some greenery, and they spend several months, you know, grazing on those greenery. And after that greenery is over, the Maldharis go and bring them back from the islands. So this is Kharai camel. So you know, so these Maldharis, Todas, Bakarwals, Gaddis. These are some of the pastoral tribes of India. So you write about these. This is one answer sheet. And the other answer sheet is, apart from writing about these, someone does this.
Yes. Indian map. Okay, sir.
Uttarakhand, Nepal, Sikkim, Bhutan, Northeast India. Bangladesh. Okay, someone draws a quick India map, you know, shows the Maldharis around Kutch. Okay, Maldhari here, Todas somewhere here, Bakarwals and Gaddis here, okay, in Himachal and Kashmir, and you know what, Maldharis, Todas, Bakarwals and Gaddis. And you know, he labels the diagram nicely like this. Bakarwals and Gaddis, Maldharis, Todas, you know, he nicely labeled, put inside a box and writes here figure. What is this figure about? Pastoral tribes of India. Tell me, who will get better marks? Someone who has just written all these things, or someone who has written plus done this? Who will get better marks?
Diagrammatically, sir.
Obviously, diagrams. Yeah, well labeled diagram. Not just well labeled diagram. Put inside proper box and you know mentioned here what is it regarding. You know, this is called the way you get in books. जैसे बुक्स में होता है, यू सी इन बुक्स, यू नो दे हैव अ डायग्राम एंड बिलो द डायग्राम इट्स रिटन व्हाट इज अबाउट. लुक एट द लेबलिंग, इट इज नॉट जस्ट हैफजर्ड लाइक दिस इज डायग्राम लाइक दिस. नो, नॉट लाइक दैट. इफ दिस इज अ डायग्राम, दिस काइंड ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइज्ड लेबलिंग एट वन लेवल, यू सी दिस द डिफरेंस, इट मेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंस. दिस स्मॉल स्मॉल थिंग्स, यू नो, एंड यू विल गेट गुड मार्क्स. एंड नाउ टेल मी, हाउ मेनी सेकेंड्स डिड इट टेक टू ड्रॉ दिस डायग्राम?
Within the 1 to 2 to 5 minutes, 3 minutes, sir.
How many seconds it would have taken? With some practice, you can make the. Joystick kind of thing, pen tab. And this is the result. If you do some practice, drawing with pen on paper is much easier. Your internet connection is unstable. What's going on? Let me see. My internet connection seems to be fine only.
Yes, sir. Fine, fine. Now fine, sir. Now
fine. Once. Fine, right?
Yes, sir. Now fine.
Yeah. Okay. So you know, 10 seconds you can draw such diagrams and present there, just 10 seconds, 20 seconds for world maps, and they add a lot of value to your answer. Your answer will definitely look much, you know, much more different. And some more things, you know, suppose you are writing with a blue pen, I used to write with a very beautiful gel pen that is called Rorito Maxtron bol ke ek pen hai. There's a pen, Rorito Maxtron. Nice pen. Okay. Write with this pen and use black ballpoint to draw this diagram. So you write with blue pen. You know, your answers is like this. You've written like blue pen.
Sir, is gel pen is allowed in the mains examination?
Yes, yes, yes. It's 100% allowed, right? You write with that, with the blue pen, and here I make a diagram with black ballpoint pen. The contrast and everything looks so nice. You know, it looks like the person is reading a book, and you know, the answer sheet looks very nice. So these are small, small things that you can make. For example, now the question is regarding pastoral tribes of the world. Okay, so you. This is California. This is South America. Africa. Saudi Arabia. Italy. Portugal and Spain. Denmark. Norway and Sweden. Okay. Pakistan. India. Sri Lanka, and like that, you know, Southeast Asia, Vietnam, China, Russia. So, you know, here I can also make Australia, New Guinea, and all those things. So,
net attack raha hai sir bar bar aapka.
Box pastoral tribes India. We already talked about. You can put, you know, here the Nuer, the Dinka, the Maasai. Those are the pastoral tribes of Africa. So like that, Weddas here, and so you know, these diagrams really, really add value to your, you know, question. Diagrams and maps. Another thing regarding diagram is, you know, if you've seen last year's anthropology paper, you would have seen. Question number one, I think sub question B, talked about Victor Turner and liminality. You know, the standard book that is recommended for anthropological theories is Upadhyay and Pandey. There's a book, Upadhyay and Pandey. Unfortunately, Upadhyay and Pandey or any standard book that is recommended does not cover all the theories that are in the syllabus. They talk mostly about the initial theories, the later theories, you know, like symbolism, like cognitive anthropology, like postmodernism. They're not given properly in many books. This guy is from symbolism, Victor Turner, and he had given a concept, liminality. While reading Victor Turner for teaching students, you know, a couple of years ago, I really liked his theory. So I did some deep research and got these concepts of liminality and all. Last year, this came in the exam and a lot of students were not aware at all regarding this. But you know, no, I had not only read this concept, I also understood and created a diagram. So you can also create a diagram for things. For example, liminality, you know, in a lot of tribes, it happens. In our Hindu society also, you know, we have a lot of Hindu or, you know, even Islamic society or many other societies, Buddhist society, Christian society, we have some rituals that mark the change of one stage of life and beginning of other stage of life. I'll take example of a tribe in Africa. They have this ritual called NKANGA. They call it Kanga. The tribe's name is NDEMBU, Dembu. So this tribe, you know, they have, you know, their this puberty ritual. When the girl has her first menstrual cycle, she now, as per the tribal custom, now she is no more a girl. She needs to take up the role of a woman in the society. She needs to take up the role of the woman. So that kind of rituals are, you know, are under the concept of liminality. So there is a preliminal stage when the girl is a girl. There is a postliminal stage, postliminal, when she is a woman. In between, there is the liminal stage, when there are rituals, you know, that are going on, a lot of rituals are happening. So, you know, this can be represented in a diagram very nicely. You know, I will share this diagram. You know, I have if any one of you are in the Telegram group of Diademy IS, I have shared this topic, this concept, and the diagram, how a diagram can be made beautifully to present this concept in the Telegram channel. So like that, you know, if you know the concept really well, you can create your own diagrams. So I created a diagram for this concept. I created a diagram like preliminality. The girl is ritually taken out. As a girl, she's outside the society, not a part of the society. Here, she returns back to the society as a woman. A diagram can be created like this. Preliminal stage, liminal stage, post-liminal stage. Okay. So diagrammatic representation of a lot of topics can happen if you know the concept. So these beautiful things are there in this in anthropology. Fine. So, you know, now, as I said, you know, the not many books. So a lot of students reading the same book, resulting in very same answer, everyone writing similar answer, how to make it different. So, you know, at Diademy, we have some value addition classes, wherein we'll, you know, the things that I showed, we'll show some small, short, easy, doable tricks to add some diagrams, maps, data, charts, values that can make your answer a little different from others. Okay. So this is one value addition. Again, another way of to add value to your answer, examples and case studies. You would say, yes, why not? Examples and case studies. Everyone gives examples. So what is such a big deal in that? The big deal is that, as I said, that, you know, everyone is reading the same books. As a result, everyone is giving the same examples. Again, not very impressive. The examiner will feel your same examples again and again. Okay. The same examples again and again. So, yeah, Sudhir, 25 seconds, you know, I may have taken, I think I took lesser than that. But you know, with some practice, you can draw the world map in 20 seconds and India map in 10 seconds with some practice and some guidance. Okay. So, you know, you end up writing, you know, giving the same examples because you are reading the same books. That happens. So how to make your answer different? One way is, again, to give examples that are not there in the book. So everyone reading about, you know, the struggle of tribes with developmental projects, everyone will come across the same, you know, Dongriya Khond. The Dongriya Khond tribe, where are they located? Which state Dongriya Khond, guys? Anyone, which state Dongriya Khonds? Okay. Has anyone replied in the chat?
Odisha, sir, Odisha.
Yes, yes. Who is this? Is it Nikhil?
Yes, sir, yes.
Very good job, Nikhil. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Maybe, you know, I have a Wi-Fi here, so that should not happen. I don't know why that is happening.
Sir, no problem.
Okay. So, yeah. Very good, Nikhil. They are a tribe in Odisha. And why are they so famous? Nikhil, do you know that?
Have you read about
Vedanta? Do you know Vedanta?
Sir, bas bauxite ka kuch scene.
Yes, yes, bauxite. Yes. So Vedanta wanted to do bauxite
Vedanta
mining.
Vedanta, Nikhil. Hmm.
What?
Nikhili bol raha hu main.
Nikhili, yeah, Nikhil, I know. Yeah. So no, Vedanta is the name of the company, Nikhil. Okay. Nikhil. Vedanta is the name of the company. They were trying to, you know, mine bauxite for making aluminium. Yeah. So this company is a big, you know, they're a multinational big company. They're so big. They are so big. Trust me, that, you know, they want to mine coal from Australia, and even Australian, you know, government is silent. Even Australian government, you know, government, the Australian people don't want, you know, their country to export coal. But Vedanta is so rich, you know, that they have bought the Australian government. They can make, you know, they can change the Australian government. They can topple the Australian government if the government doesn't, you know, provide them coal mine, you know, coal. So they are so powerful. This powerful multinational, they were defeated by this Dongriya Khond tribe. This Dongriya Khond tribe did not want to give away their Jal Jangal Jameen.
Sir, this issue is regarding to PESA Act, if I'm not wrong, sir.
Yes, very good. Very good. Awesome. Very good. So you are combining this with polity and all, and this is PESA and all is also part of our anthropology syllabus. Yes. You know, we will read about that also. Panchayat extension to scheduled areas. So yes, so they were not ready to give their, you know, forests, their rivers, their streams and their mountains. And so they fought and they fought hard and they won. You know, but the thing is that this example is very old. This happened decades ago. You cannot keep on writing the same examples. You have to find new examples. Where will the new examples come from? So every now and then, very frequently, you know, we have these things in news that this tribe, you know, something happened with this tribe, this group tribe got displaced, that tribe got displaced, you know. So those kind of current affairs have to be collected throughout the year. If you can collect, very good. If you don't, then, you know, we, you know, do that. We collect such examples throughout the year, which can help your answer to be different from others' answers. You know? So another thing, an example. So for pastoral tribes, when I talked about pastoral tribes, most of the people will say Bakarwal, Gaddis, you know, Maldharis, Todas, Indian examples. But to have a better impression, you have to give a geographically diverse set of examples. So you write your answer and you write like this, examples. Examples, one, in India, you give three tribes name. In Africa, you give three tribes name, like that. So, you know, geographically diverse examples that really, you know, will impress the examiner. Yes, this person knows her subject. Okay. Case study. What is a case study? Case study is nothing but an extended example. Case study is an extended example. Basically, it's a way of giving an example by telling a small story. You give an example by telling a small story. Okay. So you will read this in the book. You will find it in the book, you know, regarding, for example, tribal, you know, issues. May there was, you know, this British were laying a railway line. British were laying a railway line in the places dominated by the Mundas. So they, you know, to impress the Munda chiefs, what the British did, you know, they gave them a flag. They gave the British, the tribes, a flag with the picture of a, you know, railway engine. So they gave the tribes a flag with a picture of the railway engine and showed them how powerful a railway engine is. The Mundas were really impressed that, awesome, this thing is so powerful. So powerful this thing is, this engine. Let's make it our totem. What is a totem? Totem kya hota hai? Anyone? What is a totem?
Sir, it's a sign or any object which is worshipped by the tribal people.
Very good. Your name, please?
Kritika.
Kritika, very good. Yeah. So totem is a, you know, basically it,
sir,
represents the tribe.
It can be an animal also.
Yes,
or,
yes. It can be a tree, animal, fruit, you know, a rock, a mountain, a hill, or anything. Okay. Or it can be a mythical ancestor. So I may say that, you know, I am the ancestor of a tiger, and the tiger can be my, you know, totem, my tribe's totem.
It's kind of a belief system.
It's a belief system. Yes, totemism is a belief system. So,
sir, in Hindi, if we say, it can be called as Kuldevta.
Yes, totem is very similar to Kuldevta. You're correct. Totem is concept is very similar to Kuldevta as far as the Australian tribes are concerned. But in the African tribes, it is a little different. We can read that, you know, in our anthropology, there is a topic of totemism. We will see the difference. You know, one scholar went to Australia, he found out something else. And one scholar went to Africa, he found out something else. But yeah, it is very similar to our concept of Kuldevta, you know, a deity for our lineage. So, you know, usually they are symbols, you know, that they take on their flag, carry on their flag. So this Munda tribe, they took this flag and they made it their symbol. So, you know, annually they used to have some sports meeting and sports event or anything, you know, Mela Vela Hota Tha, some fair and all they used to happen, you know, have the Mundas, where all the Munda villages used to gather. So this Munda village, you know, Munda village A, this Munda village A carries this flag of the engine on it, and it tells everyone in the fair, you know, guys, this is our totem. You know how powerful it is. You know, it puffs like, you know, big fumes of, you know, steam, and then it can push and pull, and it makes such loud noise. It is so heavy. It can just, you know, push anything. It is so big and it is our totem. It is now our symbol of our village. Okay. So the other, you know, villages, they got jealous. So village B got jealous. They are also a Munda village. So they said, you know, we'll, what the heck, we'll also copy it. Now, so they also, you know, made a flag on of the, with the picture of railway engine, and they also adopted it. Next year, that fair happens, and this tribe A comes with their flag. Tribe B also come with the same flag. Now tribe A say, how can you do this, man? This is our flag. You are such a, you know, you are doing copyright infringement. You know, this is a joke. Obviously, they did not have copyright infringement, but they are saying, how can you do this? You know, you cannot copy our flag. Okay. So, Nikhil, are you still getting echo?
No, sir. No, fine.
Oh, fine. Okay. So, you know, how can you copy? So there was a big, you know, and they said, why can't we copy? This is tumhare baap ka, you know, nahi, and all those things they would have said, you know, in their language, that this is not your property, and, you know, I can also copy the flag. And then there would be a fight, and there was a fight, a bloody fight between these two. So British forces had to intervene. Now, next year, again, the fair is approaching, and the authorities in that Jangal Mahal area are worried what will happen this year. Again, they will come, you know, with all their weapons and all, and they'll start killing and fighting for this flag. What to do? Let's deploy forces, or let's cancel their fair, and let's, you know, employ 144, you know, 144 laga denge, and we will not allow them to gather on. But then there was a great scholar, S.C. Roy, Sarat Chandra Roy,
right?
Yeah, he is one of India's first and greatest anthropologists. So he said to the authorities, sir, you don't need to do that. This is not a matter of law and order. This is not a matter of gun and bullet. This is a matter of tribal faith and tribal beliefs. Do something. Give this tribe B another flag. And what will this flag have? Give them a flag. With the picture of an aeroplane. Give them a flag with the picture of an aeroplane and tell them how powerful aeroplane is. That will do. That is what the authorities did. You know, few months before the fair, they went to tribe B and they said, you know, guys, why to copy, you know, tribe A ka flag, that thing, you know, that little puny thing moves on the ground. Your flag should be this. It flies in the air. It is even more powerful. And this tribe B were impressed. They said, yes, we have seen things like this, you know, going above, flying in the air with a lot of sound, lot of noise. Yeah, we know this. Okay. So they adopt this flag and it becomes their flag. In the next fair, they come proudly with their engine flag and they come proudly with their aeroplane flag. No fight. The fight is avoided. No bloodshed. All because someone understood the tribal way of thinking, what they consider important. They don't consider life and death as more important. They consider their tribal totem as more important. So this was not a matter of law and order, matter of tribal belief. So this is what, you know, anthropologist was able to do, you know, with his knowledge of tribes. So what I just said was a story. You know, I made it more dramatic, like a story. So these kind of examples, you know, suppose the question comes, you know, role of anthropologists in tribal, tribal society improvement, you know, any kind of thing, you have this, you know, intertribal, internecine warfare, how can an anthropologist play a role? If something like that comes, you can cite this as an example, but this is not a one word example. It's like a story. So these kind of story like examples are called case studies. So case studies are beautiful weapon of making, you know, your answer look very different. But again, this case study is already there in the books.
But sir, how can we manage within the word limit, sir?
I really made it a big story. You know, it's not, you know, it can be written very, so a case study usually will take one para. So you will say that, you know, once, you know, there was a dispute between two Munda villages because one of them had got a flag bearing an engine picture with the British. And this became a big issue where a lot of violence could have taken place. So S.C. Roy intervened and he suggested a way out by, you know, giving a, you know, flag with the, you know, picture of an aeroplane, which pacified the tribe B and the bloodshed was avoided. 3-4 lines, right? I just made it up like a big story to make it interesting in the class. So case study is this kind of one para examples. okay, like a small story, one para. So, but the thing is that this case study is already there in the book. It is there in Nadeem Hasnain, the book that we read, Nadeem Hasnain for Tribal India. Yeah. So, kya kare ab? What to do? So, that's our job. In our value addition classes, we'll have more these kind of, for whichever topic, you know, we have case studies available in current affairs or anywhere, you know, in some other sources, we'll try to gather them and share with you so that you can have a different answer compared to others. Okay. That is case studies. Current affairs.
Yes, sir. The most important.
If you are not reading current affairs, then you are not a UPSC aspirant. Okay. So current affairs is so important. Without current affairs, there is no UPSC at all. Current affairs is the backbone of UPSC.
And the biggest question is, sir, how to cover the anthropological current affairs, sir?
Yes.
And how to manage with the GS study? Because the statics portion of the anthropology is very different from the current affairs. And current affairs of the anthropology is not easily get from the Hindu articles.
Yes, 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 definitely. So that is what the sources, class is about. Sir. Yes, sources, you know, again, there is
or no especially current source. Affairs, sir.
There is no single source. That is a problem. Had there been a single source for the, you know, anthropology current affairs, it would have been available on the internet and everyone would have been doing it from there.
Yes.
There's actually, okay, so before coming to the source and stuff, or, you know, where to get it from, first let me give some examples why it is important. I'll give two examples to show how they are important. So, one example. So, we all know about, so bottleneck effect. Who all have already heard about bottleneck effect? Anyone already read about bottleneck effect in our physical anthropology?
Yes, sir. Genetic bottleneck, no, sir?
Yes, 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 yes. So, can you explain to the class in short what is bottleneck?
Sir, reduction in the population, size of the population due to the environmental factors, sir, such as famine, earthquakes.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the
random chance factors.
Yes, environment calamities are responsible for the reducing in the number of the population, sir.
So I will explain this with a small, you know, tiny funny diagram so that everyone in the class can understand. So for example, this is a small settlement on a hill in say Uttarakhand. No, let me not take an example. You know, disasters have taken place. Let's not take an example of that place. So any place where there's a small settlement, and this is just an example. So this small settlement, you know, has like, you know, very few people. So this is a small settlement with very few people, and the different colors, you can see three colors, green, red, and blue. These different colors, for example, they represent the different genetic makeup. So every color represents a different genetic makeup of the person. So this person is genetically similar to this person, and this person. The blue ones are similar to the blue ones, red ones similar to the red ones. So this is some genetic, there is some genetic diversity in the population, a very small sample. Now there's a landslide. Unfortunately, there is a landslide and they die. Okay, they perish in the landslide. These three survive. Many generations, so the population has reduced a lot. Many generations and many years later, maybe this will again, the population will again grow. And again, the population will grow back to similar numbers. So again, the settlement will become big enough. But the thing is that the population will only have the population will again grow back But the population does not have anyone with this makeup, the red one, because all the individuals with that genetic makeup died. Population grew back. It grew back only from this limited stock. So the new big population has the genetic makeup of only this limited stock. This one red one is lost. Genetic diversity is lost. This is called bottleneck for one example. For example, I take a bottle. This is a bottle. Like the bottle of a whiskey or a rum, but that is because of my poor drawing. This is a normal water bottle, for example, and there are a lot of marbles in it. It is full of marbles, okay? It is full of marbles. Marbles, full of marbles. Now, what I do is I invert the bottle. Invert the bottle. Will all the marbles come out? We may have done things like this. Full of marbles. This is not water. This is marbles. I invert it. Will all the marbles be able to come out? Nikhil, will all the marbles be able to come out? When they try to come out suddenly, all of them. Guys, can you hear me? Kushal, Kaushal, Anjali, can you hear me? Kritika, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yeah. So when I invert the bottle, all of a sudden, you know, all of the marbles try to come out together and they get stuck at the neck.
Yes, sir.
And only 4 or 5 will fall out.
Yes, sir.
And the others will get stuck. So it was full of marbles. I inverted, but they get stuck and only 4 or 5 are able to fall. The rest will not fall. Why? Because of the neck of the bottle. It is narrow, much narrower. So when a population, so this is a population, this is a big population, it declines to a very small number due to some reason, and again, it again grows back to a big population. So the population passes through a kind of a neck of a bottle, and because of which, since all the marbles did not fall, this limited number of marbles do not represent all the, you know, genetic makeup of entire bottle. Only some of them were able to come out. The others were not able to. So this new small population does not represent everyone here. And now since the new big population grows out of this small population, it will not have all the genetic features of the previous population. This is called bottleneck, okay? So for bottleneck, there was an awesome, you know, theory in very popular. It was in Vogue. It is not given in many books. But it is, you know, due to research for teaching and all, I have come across this. There's a theory that around 75,000 years ago, there was in... So where do we have most of the earthquakes and volcanoes? Most of the earthquakes and volcanoes, where do you find them? Guys, geography idea, where do we have most of the volcanoes and earthquakes? Someone has responded. I am sure it will be right. Okay. No. This is something else. Sorry, sir. Power cut in my place. I joined now. I miss your live video. Live in Pacific Ring. Very good. Very good. Very good. And okay. So someone missed out. Barthak, you missed out. But don't worry. Okay. Can you share this video after this live end? I think the video is being recorded and the video can be shared with you. I will talk for that. Okay. Right. I'll speak for that. And okay, yeah, ring of fire, Pacific ring of fire, earthquake and all happen very frequently. Yes, Sudhir. And someone else has responded. Sudhir has responded and Sefalika has responded. Very good, Sefalika. Very good, Sudhir. So Pacific ring of fire, where all this, you know, these take place. So now name one of the countries. Name one of the countries in Pacific ring of fire. Any one country in Pacific Ring of Fire? Okay, who has responded? Japan, yes. Yes.
Indonesia.
So, yes. So Japan, Kritika said Japan was said by Sudhir. Sefalika ne Japan bola. And two people said Indonesia. Sudhir said Indonesia and...
Indonesia, sir.
And Bharat Kumar also said Indonesia, yeah. my interest, the country of my interest is Indonesia. So around 75,000 years ago, see, Japan is also definitely a ring fire country, ring of fire, but Indonesia may something happened. There was a volcano called Toba, T-O-B-A, Toba. It exploded. And this was a super volcanic explosion. Super volcanic explosion. Causing a volcanic winter. Now, what is volcanic winter? Someone please say, you know, you cannot write everything in the chat. I think you will not be able to describe the entire thing. What is a volcanic winter? Can anyone tell? Volcanic winter? Anyone, volcanic winter? Okay. I'll explain what is volcanic winter. So,
is it a sudden lowering of the Earth's temperature because of the particles that have been brought by the volcano?
Awesome, Kritika. Very nice. Bahut achha, Mishra ji. Very good.
Volcano ash.
Yeah. So, what happens? Yes. Yes, volcano ash. Yeah, Nikhil. So, you know, it was a super massive volcanic explosion which, you know, ejected so much of not only lava, but so much of ash and other particulate matter that went across the troposphere and entered stratosphere. Very high, you know, maybe 12 kilometers, 10 kilometers high. And the stratosphere, may even know, the air movement is not as, you know, regular as troposphere. Troposphere, may we have all the air movement and weather phenomena. Stratosphere, may weather movement utna nahi hota hai. So, all the dust particles and ash, they stayed there in the stratosphere for a very long time, almost 1 or 2 decades. So when something like this happens, this is called negative climate forcing. All these things are climate, you know, this is a concept of ecology, negative climate forcing. So what happened is, because of the, you know, covering, you know, the entire earth was covered with this layer of ash and dust for around a decade. So sunlight was blocked. When sunlight is blocked, photosynthesis stops. When photosynthesis stops, green plants start to die off. And anyone who has read anything about, you know, food chain will know, if plants are dying off, you know, entire life will suffer. So the theory is that 75,000 years ago, there was a supermassive Toba explosion, which led to volcanic winter, because of which the plants died, because of which a lot of animals died. You know, all the animals that our ancestors used to eat around 75,000 years ago, there would have been a few million of humans on the face of the earth, and they would have been Homo sapiens. By 75,000 years, Homo sapiens had already developed. So Homo sapiens, they were not getting enough food. And the theory is that from millions, Homo sapien numbers came down to just 10,000. So a bottleneck happened. Majority of the population perished. Very few survived. And after this, you know, gradually the conditions improved. So again, the population grew back to today's around 8 billion. And that is why when a lot of scholars say that, you know, racism is a myth, because if I compare myself with anyone in Africa, we'll find that 99.99% of the genetic makeup is same. Why so similarity? Why so, you know, so much similarity? Because the theory is that the similarity is so much between two humans because they all have come from a very small stock. Very small stock. 10,000 people are the ancestors of the 8 billion today, and many more billions and billions to come. Sabka ancestor are, you know, are these 10,000 people. So that's why such less diversity. And this thing happened because of bottleneck effect. So this is one classic example of bottleneck in human race. But coming to our booster, that is current affairs, what happens now? So just 2 years ago, there were some diggings, some excavation in two places. One is a place called Dhaba, not the Dhaba where we eat roti and tadka, a Dhaba in Madhya Pradesh, place called Dhaba in Madhya Pradesh, and Malawi Lake. Where will we find Malawi Lake? Which continent?
अफ्रीका सर.
अफ्रीका, यस निखिल. सो मलावी लेक एंड ढाबा, दीज टू प्लेसेस में डिगिंग एंड एक्सकेवेशंस वर डन एंड व्हाट वाज फाउंड. सो वी फाउंड अ लेयर डिपॉजिटेड, अ लेयर ऑफ एश वाज डिपॉजिटेड. यस, सो लेयर ऑफ एश डिपॉजिटेड, अ थिक लेयर ऑफ एश डिपॉजिटेड. इट सेज यस, टोबा एक्सप्लोजन डिड टेक प्लेस. सो टोबा सुपर एक्सप्लोजन टुक प्लेस बिकॉज अ लेयर विच इज अराउंड 75,000 ईयर्स ओल्ड इज ऑफ एश अक्रॉस द ग्लोब एवरीवेयर. So yes, the earth had a lot of ash, you know, a layer of ash was deposited on the earth 75,000 years ago. But then something else also was found out. Our ancestors make stone tools. They used to make stone tools like hand axes, okay, like cleavers and choppers, you know, so those kind of tools, you know, were made by our ancestors. So the number of stone tools made by man found in the layer before 75,000 years and the layer after 75,000 years, there was no marked change, no sudden change, no massive change. So number of tools found before the explosion, after the explosion remain the same, which means that the number of tool makers also remains the same, which means human race did not have a bottleneck. Human race did not decline to 10,000 people 75,000 years ago. So this theory that has been there for decades has been rejected by this current affairs. This is the power of current affairs. Another example. So we know, we must have heard about Australopithecus. Everyone has heard about Australopithecus?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
One of our ancestors. Yes. After Australopithecus?
Yes, sir.
We have?
Yes, sir.
Homo erectus.
Yes, sir.
You can, you know, put in Homo habilis somewhere in between. Homo erectus. Then we had Homo neanderthalensis. And we have Homo sapiens.
Yes.
That is us. How old is Homo sapiens? For how many years has Homo sapiens been on this earth? When did Homo sapiens evolve? So a theory that was there or is still there. Abhi bhi hai. It has not been rejected because studies are still going on. The theory is that 2 lakh years ago. So Australopithecus around 3 million years ago. But after all this evolution, Homo sapiens, the theory says Homo sapiens evolved around 2 lakh years ago. 2 lakh years, 200,000 years ago, Homo sapiens evolved. This theory has been there for many decades. Last year. Okay, one more theory. Apart from this, another theory, you know, I love drawing Africa. I keep on drawing Africa whenever the opportunity comes. So this is Africa. Okay. There is something here in Africa, Eastern Africa. It's a geographical feature. What is it called in Eastern Africa?
Nile.
No, this is not the river. Okay. This is a geographical feature called the Great Rift Valley. Great Rift Valley. You know, plate tectonic movements are going on. And this part is moving this side, this part is moving this side. If humans exist for the next few million years, we will find out that Africa has become like this. Africa will be in two parts, will be broken. You know, this rift is pulling apart. Africa is breaking up. So this Rift Valley, you know, Great Rift Valley is called the cradle of life, cradle of humanity. Why? Because all the fossils of human ancestors are found here. So Homo sapiens, not Neanderthals. Neanderthals developed in Europe, but Australopithecus, Homo erectus, Homo sapiens, all of them seem to have developed here and then migrated to the rest of the world. So Great Rift Valley of East Africa is considered the cradle of humanity because all hominid fossils are first found here and then at other places. It seems that all of them evolved here and then migrated to other parts. One theory. Second theory, Homo sapiens, 2 lakhs years old. They evolved in Africa 2 lakh years ago and then migrated to rest of the world. These two theories have been there for a very long time. Okay. But the last year, in Africa, there was excavation here in Morocco at a place called Jebel Irhoud. Jebel Irhoud is a place in Morocco in Northwest Africa where a fossil was found, which was a Homo sapien fossil. And this fossil is 3 lakh years old. So one fossil pushes the history of Homo sapiens back by 1 lakh years. So this theory rejected. Second thing, it is Northwest Africa. In Northwest Africa, a fossil older than the fossils found in, you know, found in Great Rift Valley. So, cradle of humanity, greatest Eastern Africa, no more. This theory also rejected. So, current affairs is very powerful in anthropology. Very powerful. But now coming to Nikhil's question, where to find these from? Unfortunately, there is no single source. For teaching, we do a lot of research. And doing research, we come across a lot of research papers and articles and stuff which are not there in the Hindu or the Indian Express or any of the monthly magazines. And we collect them. So you can also do that research, you know, but then when will you study GS?
Time-based, yes, sir.
Yeah. So for that reason, you know, we have these value addition classes. There may be separate value addition classes or no separate class. When, you know, when teaching about the Homo sapiens, I can share this. When teaching about, you know, bottleneck effect, I can share the Dhaba, you know, tool finds and all those things. So these value adding current affairs will be shared for whichever topic, you know, I have collected the current affairs so far, or and keep on collecting, you know, for teaching, I keep on doing more and more research. So I'll keep getting these things and keep on sharing this so that you write an answer. Suppose the answer is regarding bottleneck. So you write answer, write, aisa likha, you know, you add an extra heading in your answer. Recent finds. Under recent finds, you write about what we discussed in the current affairs and then give a conclusion that yes, Homo sapiens, you know, as of now, the theory says 2 lakh years old, but this theory may not be for too long because this recent find, a lot of studies are going on and very soon we may find out that Homo sapiens are 3 lakh years old. So that kind of a conclusion. So if you add this an extra heading of recent finds and give this current affair, trust me, the examiner is going to love your answer sheet. He will forget his fight with his wife and he will give you marks. Okay. So this is the power of current affairs. Now coming to some boring part. Yes, we are preparing for UPSC. When someone tells me that, what is the difference? So I'm in Calcutta. I'm in West Bengal. So we also have WBCS, West Bengal Civil Services. Okay. And so someone says, you know, WBCS is already there. Why to go for UPSC? So we proudly say, you know, guys, WBCS is about mugging up. You have to mug up. UPSC is about concepts. You have to understand, you know, to apply brain. All those things we say. But the sad reality is that in UPSC also, you have to mug up. So for those who have read the strategy of one Sachin Gupta, he got rank All India rank 3 with anthropology, I think 2017. Sachin Gupta, if you read or seen his videos, he says, you know, that I mugged up things and went in the exam hall and vomited it. So he's using very direct and gross language. But yes, a lot of things have to be mugged up. So the name of the authors, the name of the books, the scholars' names, the name of the theories, the name of the places, or the name of the fossils, Australopithecus, you know, Robustus, this, that, you know, a lot of things, you know, you'll have to mug up. So mugging up is important. You, for scoring good marks, you will have to mug up certain things. For example, the question comes about, say, what is culture? So you will have to give the definition of culture and you have to mug it up. Yes, you can give a roundabout definition that according to Mr. This, culture is this, you know, but you will get better marks if you give the exact definition, you know, that, you know, according to who is the person who has given the definition? Okay, fine. So, you know,
Tyler,
kya definition and what is the definition?
Sorry, I don't remember.
Yeah. So, you know, he says that, you know, culture is that whole, which, you know, that includes your KBAMLC, cult, you know, your knowledge, beliefs, arts, morals, laws and customs, and any other habits acquired by man as a part of the society. This is his definition of culture. Okay. This is the definition of culture. So I thought that I should not miss a single word of the definition. For that, I, you know, made this short form. Some, you know, I had also prepared like this. KBCMAL. KBC, kaun banega crorepati? KBC mein jaake, I win money, maal. Some people say, you know, maal, paisa. So KBC, maal. Knowledge, beliefs, customs, you know, knowledge, beliefs, arts, morals. So morals and arts and laws. I first made this, but then I rejected this. I went with this only because this is the order of his definition. In the definition, he has given it in this order: knowledge, beliefs, arts, morals, laws, and customs, and on any other habits acquired by man as part of the, you know, society. So you have to mug up certain things. ये करना पड़ेगा. ये आपको, this definition has to be mugged up. You have to mug up that the person who has given the definition is Mr. E.B. Tyler. And you've also got to mug up that he gave this definition in his book, Primitive Cultures. And also, if you can do this also, that it was published in 1871. If you give the definition E.B. Tyler in the book Primitive Cultures, 1871, full marks. Some mugging up is required. Okay. So, yeah, this is, you know, you should be, you know, making sure that you remember definitions, authors, names, scholars, books, years, you know, because a question comes regarding, say, tribal issues. The question is on tribal issues. So anyone who is a decent student knows the tribal issues. What are the issues tribals face? You know, displacement, alcoholism, poverty, lack of education, lack of health, government schemes not penetrating, you know, violence against SCSTs, a lot of things, you know, constitutional provisions are not utilized properly. The fifth schedule areas don't give them proper rights. Sixth schedule, the state governments are objecting. A lot of things are there. Everyone can answer that. But then that is a GS answer also. What is the difference between a GS and an optional answer? In the optional answer, you've got to give the name of the scholars. You've got to give, you know, some people, some studies conducted, okay, some books, some writing, some papers. So for tribal issues, you have to mention that government constituted a Zaza panel, Zaza committee, which has given the following recommendations. These kind of things have to be mentioned. Zaza is the name of the person, Virginius Zaza. Okay. The question comes regarding, say, culture personality school. So you have to say Margaret Mead in her book, Coming of Age in Samoa, written in 1929, has given this idea. So you have to give the name of the scholars and books. Very important. Cannot do without it. Okay. Last one. Last but not the least, the last booster, paper one and paper two integration. So yes, paper one, paper two have separate things covered apart from archaeology. Archaeology is common to both. Archaeology is there in paper one also. Paper one is about world archaeology. Paper two is Indian archaeology. Apart from that, paper one, you know, has separate things. You know, it has the physical anthropology part, genetics, you know, the anthropological theories and all those things. And this is, you know, this paper two is about the, you know, Indian villages, Indian culture, Indian society, the Indian tribes, Indian archaeologists and all those things. So separate things. But if you can write an answer, the question has come for paper one, but if you can insert a paper two ka idea also, question has come for paper two, you can insert a paper one ka idea, the examiner is going to think that, yes, this person has read the subject holistically, nicely, and is able to actually integrate because he knows his subject. One example. In paper two, okay. In paper two, we have a, you know, concept of communalism. Communalism is also inside in our syllabus. Communalism. One of the communal, you know, things that, one of the things that stokes communal fight in India, communal riots in India, is beef, you know, cow meat. The meat of cow is a very sensitive thing, and it is, you know, it has the potential to be at the root of communal riots. This beef, the comes from, you know, this issue comes from the respect for the cow that the Hindu society has, traditional Hindu society has. This is a paper two thing. But I can insert paper one idea here. In paper one, in the theories, unit six, you have a theory called cultural materialism. Anyone read about cultural materialism?
Not yet, sir.
Who is the scholar who has given this theory? Remember, Nikhil?
Not, no, sir.
Marvin Harris.
Okay? Yes.
So Marvin Harris is a very important scholar in our anthropology. And you know what? A lot of the recommended textbooks don't give this thing in detail. These theories are not given a proper detail in a lot of standard textbooks. So for teaching purpose, I have done some research, and for the theories that have evolved later. Older theories are given in detail in the books, but later theories are not given that much in detail. So these kind of theories, you know, we'll discuss very nicely in our class. Yeah. So Marvin Harris in cultural material, he came to India to do some field work. He went to Uttar Pradesh and he asked them that, why do you worship cow or why do you respect cow? They said that cow is the reason is religious. Religiously, the cow is, you know, in our society, in Sanskrit, the cow is called Kamdhenu, which provides all we want. You know, it's a Bhagwan ka vardhan. It's a, you know, it's a God-given, God gift. It's a, you know, it's our mother. It's, you know, we respect and worship the cow because our religion says so. It is part of our religion. Then he said, okay, what about the male and the female? The answer was yes, male and female, both of them are sacred to us. Then Marvin Harris did a field study. He found out that the number of male and female calves at the birth was same. But in adulthood, in grown-up condition, he found the ratio is to be 1:3. For every 3 or 4, even more, this, you know, females were way more than the males in the grown-up, you know, cows. But at birth, they were same. So why this is happening? He found out that in the times of shortage, when there is shortage of food grains, shortage of, you know, feed for cows and all, when there is a drought, in drought times, you know, not enough food for the cows, lot of, you know, people, they used to sell their male calf to butchers, which, because of shortage, you know, they don't have money, they don't have enough feed, so we cannot feed everyone, so let's feed the female cow because she gives milk and she will give more calves and stuff. Plus coming of tractors are there now to, you know, till the fields. So the male cow has not, you know, has lost economic importance. So the this is not my theory, this is Marvin Harris's theory, that it is not because of religion, but it is because of economic reasons that the female cow is worshipped. This is cultural materialism, you know. So you can insert this case study, the study by Marvin Harris, his, you know, analysis when talking about the issue of communalism and beef and stuff. So if you can, you know, link paper one and paper two like this, and that too, I have not linked with any thing, but I have linked with an anthropological theory. This is an amazing thing. You know, the paper, those who check the paper, they want that student should know other things, but student must know the theories. You should know the theories very well. Theory is the backbone of anthropology for any optional. You know, if you are a student of any subject, you should know the theories that are there in that, you know, subject. You should know the theory.
Which resources is very, very good for the covering all theories? Particular,
okay, I'll, yeah, I'll after this, you know, after this is over, I will discuss that. Okay, you ask and I will reply. Okay, after this, okay, Nikhil. So yeah, so you know, you should know the theories. And if you theory is given in paper one, not in paper two, if I'm able to link a paper two ka, you know, question with a theory in paper one, examiner will be very impressed. Another example of linking. We have a topic in paper two, traditional Indian society. Traditional Indian society. Under traditional Indian society, one of the factors is patriarchy. And one of the repercussions of patriarchy is, you know, that women can't do this, women can't do that, these things only men can do, women can't do, women should not go out, women let the men work, women do household chores, they will take care of the children, those kind. So gender roles, gender segregation of roles. So these roles are only for males, these are only for females. No mixing and no, you know, swapping of roles and all. Stringent patriarchy. This you can link with paper one mein. There's a scholar, Margaret Mead. Which school of thought she belongs to? Anyone? Margaret Mead? Which school of thought in the anthropological theories? Margaret Mead? Okay. She belongs to culture personality school. Okay, fine. So Margaret Mead did a study. And that study was published in a book called Sex and Temperament in Three Primitive Societies. It was a study, the study was named this, Sex and Temperament in Three Primitive Societies, where she studied three primitive cultures. There were three island societies. The islands are located nearby, one island here, one here, one here. The tribe that lives here is the Arapesh. Here, Chambuli, and here, Mundugumor. These are name of tribes. So that is where mugging up comes. Arapesh, Chambuli, and Mundugumor. Name of the book. All these things, you know, you have to mug up. So these three tribes, they are very similar, you know, conditions and everything. But she found out that in this tribe, for example, men and women, they do, you know, the roles that are expected in our society. Men will go out, women will stay inside. That happens in this society. In this society, the opposite happens. The women go out, the men, you know, stay at home. Okay. The women are the most aggressive. They go out, they fight, you know, they have all the outside, you know, adventurous things, and men take care of the children, stay at home. And in this society, men, women, both, you know, stay at home, and they both are like very, you know, jisko hum log, you know, in our society, we'll call it, you know, feminine. So in this society, both male and female are feminine and not aggressive, not fighting, not screaming, not abusing all the time, you know, abusive language, deke baat karna and all those things, you know, hurling abuses and those things don't happen with men and women. Both are, you know, effeminate. In this society, both are very masculine type, you know, both of them, you know, are aggressive, fighting, competing. And in this society, the men stay at home, the women go out and all those things. So she found out in three societies, the gender roles are so different. So she said, it's not nature. It's actually nurture. Which means it's not biology, but it's culture. It's not biological. Biologically, aisa nahi hai ki biologically women are weak. Biologically, women cannot do this. Women cannot do that. The gender roles are not based on biology. The gender roles are because the society, the culture decided to give this role to men, this role to women. It's all culture specific. It's not nature. It's nurture. How the society has nurtured them. The society has nurtured the boys saying, you know, you're a boy. You're not supposed to cry. You know, you're supposed to fight. You're not supposed to, you know, sob. You're not supposed to, you know, have tears in your eyes. You need to be strong and all those things, you know. And to the girl, it is said, you know, why are you speaking so loudly? You know, you'll get married tomorrow and go in someone's house. You will shout like this. No, you should stay silent. You know, even if something is wrong, you know, doing something wrong with you, keep quiet. Don't shout. Those kind of things. These are not biology. This is nurturing. This is culture. So gender roles don't depend on biology or genetics. The gender roles are mostly what the society from childhood teaches them to be. Okay. So patriarchy is not, patriarchy has no scientific biological basis. Patriarchy has a cultural basis. So this, doing this, I linked a topic of paper 2 with a topic of paper 1. Right, guys? Correct? Okay.
Yes, sir.
So if you can link like this, you know, and you can do this only once you have finished the syllabus properly, understood the syllabus properly. And wherever I can find, you know, a links where you can link, I will share with you, we'll discuss like this, you know, this came to my mind and I just discussed this thing. So as and when we have this kind of linking things, you know, where we can link and insert paper two in paper one, paper one in paper two, we'll discuss in our class and we'll try to use in our answers to make our answers different from others. So that is basically from my side this five boosters, and together we can definitely ace anthropology. Just one small information that since you have joined the Didemy this video, you know, this webinar at Didemy, we have some courses like, you know, for 2021, those who have clear 2021 prelims want to write 2021 mains, for them we have a program of answer writing. Okay, 10 tests plus 10 classes to discuss those tests, plus value addition, like, you know, diagrams and those things. For 2022, we have two things. One is a full-fledged course, which will have your classes and everything. Well, there will be 40 classes of 2.5 hours each, 2.5 hours classes, 40 classes, you know, wherein both paper one, paper two will be covered. And at the end of this full-fledged course, we'll have a test series also, part of the course only. You know, but the test series, definitely there will be, you know, tests, but we will not put you directly into a full-fledged test series. Throughout these 40 classes, every second or third class, we'll have a lot of small mini tests. 5 questions, 10 questions, 7 questions, 5 questions, 7 questions. Aise karte karte, what happens? You build up a practice of writing a test series. By the time the course is over, by the time we go into full-fledged test series, you already have the habit of writing, you know, because those who are preparing for some time will know the most difficult part is to, you know, start writing answers. It's very difficult. You know, we all say, hey, boss, bahut ho gaya. From tomorrow, I am going to religiously, you know, start writing answers. What I will do is I will open the internet. I will go to Insights on India. I will take those 8-9 questions that they give. I will write it. I will put it, you know, scan it and put it. And, you know, we will review each other's answers. From tomorrow, I'm going to do it. You say this and you go to sleep. The next morning you wake up, you open the website, you look at the question. Oh, I think I'm not prepared for this question. Next question. Oh, I don't know what to write in this question. Next third question. Oh yeah, yeah, I know this. And then you start writing a perfect answer. Okay, I can add this also, that also, you know, in your efforts to write a perfect answer, you end up, you know, writing 45 minutes for one question. So that is not a writing practice. You know, so this kind of writing practice will not help. So we have this kind of an inclined plane. You gradually go up. An inclined plane, you gradually go up, you know, with some small tests. The number of questions keep on increasing. By the time you reach the full-fledged test series, you have already a good practice of writing. That is part of this full-fledged test series. Then we have this, you know, three-stage answer writing. This is a different course which only includes answer writing and mock test. But it is a three-stage answer writing practice where, first of all, for around 4 months, we give you 2 questions every day. 2 questions every day for 4 months. This covers the entire syllabus. After this, there are, you know, 6 sectional tests. Full 250 marks for 6 sectional tests. And then prelims will come, prelims will happen. And after prelims, we will have 4, you know, full syllabus tests. 2 for paper 1, 2 for paper 2. So these are the different programs. This is only for 2021 mains. This is for 2022 full-fledged course plus classes plus answer test series plus answer writing. And this is a three-stage answer writing one, which is 2 questions, then 2 questions for 4 months, then, you know, 6 sectional tests, and then 4 full-fledged tests. These are different, you know, courses that we have. Now, if you want to know about these courses, you can contact Didemy, you know, contact numbers that are there on the website. Because I'm not very, you know, I'm the teaching faculty, so I don't have idea about the fee structure and all. Now, coming to Nikhil. Nikhil, you're asking something about theory.
Sir, I have to learn a lot to ask you.
Yeah. But
before that, please tell me this theory portion.
Yeah, so theory sources. Now, another thing is that the standard source that is given for theory is a book called Upadhyay and Pandey. Upadhyay and Pandey. This is a good book, very good book, you know, but a lot of later theories are not covered properly. And unfortunately, there is no single book, you know, that covers all the theories nicely. Some books cover the later theories nicely. Some cover earlier theories nicely. There is Braintree also, where theories are not covered nicely again, the later theories.
Most of the theories which are in our syllabus are covered by this Upadhyay and Pandey.
Yeah, most of them are there. Most of them are there. Some later theories like postmodernism and all are not there. So for this, what we can do is, you know, those the things that are not there, you will not miss out on those, you know, because you know, you can do it yourself, you know, going through internet and preparing it, you know, from different sources. You can do that as well. And if you join us, then, you know, we have already done this. So like, you know, I gave you an example of Victor Turner and liminality. Liminality question came last year, but in 2018 itself, you know, I had liminality in my notes along with a diagram. So lot of and Victor Turner ka other concepts are also there, which may come in the coming years, which are not there in the books, you know. But, you know, we have prepared those materials from different sources for the students. Like, you know, Victor, he also gave a concept of anti-structure. He gave a concept of social drama. He gave a concept of communitas. So anti-structure. These are not there in any of the standard books. Communitas. Social drama. So sir, liminality was a concept that came. These may come later. Yeah, yeah. Anindu. Yeah, sorry, Nikhil, tell me.
Sir, can you please explain in detail how to start the anthropology? Means from which books I have to start? And which portion should I cover the first? Means the paper one or paper two?
Okay.
Because, sir, I already started my preparation from last 2 months. I am now in Old Rajendranagar. I am a classroom student of the next IAS.
But
but I could not attend any classes for the optional because how to start anthropology.
Okay. So first thing, paper one or paper two, which to start with? That depends on you. I would say paper one, because, you know, paper two, a lot of parts we already know about. You know, the tribal things, you when you read, you will see that, okay, I'm kind of aware of these. When you read the Indian social system, you know, where sati and you read about caste system, you read about...
I read, sir, like a Peanut. I completed Peanut, sir. I completed Indian Anthropology by Nadeem Hasnain.
Yes.
And I complete my SCRT Kerala State Board.
Very good. You know, the first thing is to start with the SCRT Kerala, which you have already done. Fantastic. Yes. Now, start with paper one will be my suggestion. In paper one, you know, which books to study, which not to study. I just 2 days back, you know, I have put it on the book list. You know, unit wise. So unit.
Please explain one, again, sir, which books should
I have put that on our Telegram group. You know, so do you have the link of the Telegram group?
Yes, sir. Today I get the link.
Yes. So join that Telegram group. I think when you join Telegram, you can access, you know, the material, earlier material also. Before you join that material also, you can access on Telegram. So when you join Telegram, you know, just 2 days ago, I have, you know, put the book list of paper one. Unit wise. So unit 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 from this source. Unit 2, 3, 4 from this source. I have put the detailed book list for paper 1 2 days ago on the Telegram group. Join that, you will get the book list. Today or tomorrow, I will share the book list of paper 2 on that Telegram channel. Okay.
All that books are more than sufficient to get the good score.
Yes.
In the...
So you have to finish those books.
Yes, sir.
Read them, revise them multiple times. First thing, and then you have to attend. You know, you have to attend the discussions that we have. You know, because, you know, unless you discuss, you will not be able to put that in. One second, Kritika. So, you know, so those books are sufficient. But along with the books, you also need to revise, and then you also need to write answers and discuss, and, you know, ask questions. You know, those kind of things. So those books are sufficient, but with the books, we also need to do answer writing practice and revision. Okay, Nikhil?
Answer the one more question, please. From when I start my answer writing, sir? Firstly, I completed with all that books, and then I went to for the answer writing, or start with the reading also?
You can do that as well, or you can do one more thing, you know, you can finish topic wise. So like, you know, like we have in our classes. So topic, say unit 1.1, 1.2, 1.3 covered, then a mini test on those topics. Then chapter 2 3 4 covered, a mini test on chapter 2 3 4.
And sir,
we do that in our class. You can do that as well, you know, because what happens is by the time you finish the entire syllabus, you have already forgotten what you started with, right? So it's always good to keep on giving tests along with studying different chapters. Okay,
sir, tell me when I use Braintrees, sir. Braintrees.
Yeah. So I have put there, you know, as I said in the Telegram channel, you go there. I have put which written there for which topics you have to use Braintree.
Okay, sir.
Okay,
sir.
Yeah, welcome. Yeah, Kritika.
Sir, can you please share that in a PDF format, because that file is not supported in my phone. And
okay.
And sir, right, one more thing. So I have not heard about SCRT books of Kerala. So what is this?
Okay. So
available in the Telegram, you can collect.
Yeah. So SCRT is what, you know, they are the state board books of Kerala. Kerala state class, they are the board books. Yeah. Class 11, 12 books. They are beautiful books. You know, if someone wants to understand basically what is anthropology before they start going into the main books, they are beautiful. You can, you know, in 2-3 days, you can religiously sit and finish them. And then you will understand the basic things about anthropology. What is anthropology?
Will it be available here in Delhi?
It will be available. You can get it in PDF format on internet only.
Actually, it's easier for me to read hard copy. That's why.
I think you can get. You know, I usually, you know, download PDF. Someone has put it in the chat. Let me see. SCRT Kerala books, where I can get them. I think you will get Rajinder Nagar. I don't think anything. There is anything that is not available as a handy.
I purchased from old Rajinder Nagar market. It is available here.
Yeah. Okay. So you can get that. Yes. So you know, what you will do is class 11, 12 SCRT books. Ek bar, finish them. Read them once. Okay. Read them pyar se. Achse se, once you read them, you will understand the gist of anthropology. The entire syllabus, you will have a brief overview. And then you can start with the main books. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Anjali, you have a question? Anjali is typing something, I believe. No. Okay, guys. So join the Telegram group. And
Excuse me, sir. You have told that SCRT book, right, sir? Could you please share in the Telegram channel, sir?
You want me to share the SCRT books in the Telegram channel? I will do that.
If you have any soft copy of it,
I have it. I will share it.
Yeah, it will be useful. I'll share it.
Great, I will do that.
And I'm just a beginner of anthropology, sir. I'm deciding to which course to join, which institute to join anthropology. So I want a strategy to for the anthropology and the sources for the anthropology to read for the topic wise. And
okay.
In the syllabus paper 1.1, something you have shared, right, sir? Like that, if I could.
Okay. So, Suraj, right? Suraj Sheikh.
Yes, sir.
I'll answer all your questions. So, first question of Suraj is regarding the resources.
Yes, sir.
So, resources, Telegram channel. For resources, Telegram channel. Okay. In the Telegram channel, I have given the book list of paper 1. I had given in a Word format. I'll put it in PDF format. You will be able to get that. Strategy. Okay. Before strategy, you said that you want to decide which course to join. Okay. So for that, I think tomorrow is Sunday. I think on Monday, or if time permits, we can have on Sunday also. Let me see. We will have a counseling. We provide one-on-one counseling wherein I discuss with the students what are their needs. I mean, whether they want to go for answer writing. They have some students, you know, some of the students are seniors, you know, they have already finished the syllabus. They only want answer writing. So for them, we have a different course. For some, they want to go through the course discussions, classes also. So depending on that, we'll do a counseling with you, Suraj, and, you know, we'll discuss what suits you the best.
Okay.
And strategy, sir? Obviously, you know, strategy, just one second, Kritika. Strategy is something, you know, which I cannot discuss on this video. I can make a separate video for that, or we can have a separate webinar for that. Or, you know, if you join, then we are definitely going to start the course in like a week or so. So in the class only, I can start the first class. We'll discuss the strategy part and then we'll go ahead.
Okay. That's fine. Okay.
Because strategy will take some time. You know, strategy will take some time. What I discussed today, the 5 boosters, they are one part of the strategy, a little small part of the strategy. Other things also need to be discussed. Okay.
Yeah. You have shared the paper 1, like 1.1, read from this book, from 1.2, read from this book.
Yeah. It's there in Telegram.
Paper 2 is a dynamic dynamic subject, like dynamic mm-hmm. topics, mm-hmm. is there any books that you can recommend?
Yes, paper two. Yeah, I will put that in the Telegram channel. But since there are not too many books, I'm telling you some books names now only. So for the, you know, there is one book called Indian Anthropology. Indian Anthropology by Nadeem Hasnain. Nadeem Hasnain.
Okay.
Nadeem, N-A-D-E-E-M, Nadeem Hasnain. Yeah. Indian Anthropology by Nadeem Hasnain. Okay. And one book is Tribal India by Nadeem Hasnain. So okay. both by Nadeem Hasnain. Indian Anthropology by Nadeem Hasnain. Tribal India by Nadeem Hasnain. These two books will cover majority of the paper two syllabus. Some small topics will remain like the archaeology part and all. For that, you know, we will cover from the books that are common to paper one and paper two, which is, you know, I have put in the Telegram and I'll put again. But to start with, buy these two books, Indian Anthropology by Nadeem Hasnain and Tribal India by Nadeem Hasnain. And you can start with that.
Tribal India.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Tribal India, yeah. Indian Anthropology, Nadeem Hasnain, that is one book. Tribal India by Nadeem Hasnain is another book.
Thank you.
Okay.
Sir, can you please share your contact?
Okay.
Actually, sir, I am also from West Bengal and I have also been giving WBCS exam. So I wanted to talk about that.
Okay, Kritika. Okay, fine. So for WBCS, you can... Okay, fine. Let me see.
Sir,
can you see the chat?
Yes, sir.
Let me see if can you see what I'm typing? Can you see the numbers I'm typing?
No, sir.
Unless you send it, will not be visible.
Okay, let me see. I'm not very, you know, tech friendly here. I mean, but let me see. Kritika, have you put anything? Yeah, Kritika has put something. Let me see, Kritika. Can you see anything now, Kritika?
No, sir. So you have to send it whatever you have written. Yes, sir. Now.
Okay. Okay. So this is for, you can contact me for this WBCS. So you gave the prelims this time?
Yes, sir. I have.
How was it?
Sir, it was nice, but I have not calculated my marks yet. Because after the prelims, this UPSC paper was there.
Yeah. Right. Correct. Okay, no issues. If you are preparing for UPSC, you will sail through WBCS. So it won't be very difficult.
So once I have given my mains exam.
So then you are already a pro. So should not.
No,
be
sir,
a challenge.
But I was not able to qualify. 2019 mains exam I had given.
It's okay. You know, but what happens? You know, WBCS and UPSC. There is one difference. You know, I'll tell you. You know, we'll speak.
Okay,
I'll tell
sir.
You regarding this.
Okay.
Ticket regarding WBCS. Okay.
Thank you,
guys. So, yeah, welcome. Guys, anything else, you know, for the book? So one question everyone will have regarding the book list. So I'll put that in the Telegram group. For paper one, I've already put, but I'll modify it to a PDF format so that everyone can open. Paper two book list also I'll provide today or tomorrow. So book list will be there. Strategy, it will be discussed in the class. Telegram ID. Telegram ID. Okay. Does anyone have that right now with them? Telegram ID. Anindo sir, are you there? Anindo sir, are you there with us? Anindo sir is not there. Okay. Let me. 1 second. Telegram ID. Okay. See, who is asking this? Okay. So what I will do is, you know, I will ask everyone to, I will ask the Didemy people to share the Telegram ID with everyone. Just one second, guys. I will ask the Didemy people to share.
Anthropology optional. DRDMIS.
You put it in the chat? Have you put it in the chat? Let me see. No. Okay, fine. So those who don't have it, you will get it, you know, because I will ask the DRDMI people to share it because right now I think I don't have it. I had written it down somewhere, but I'm not able to find it right now. Okay. Anything else, guys? P people anything else
no,
apart
sir.
From the book list and strategy?
No,
okay,
sir.
Fine.
So,
okay,
thanks.
So
thanks
you know, with that we can... thanks a lot.
Talk with you, sir, and thanks for your help.
Okay.
Definitely.
Okay. Thank you. This is Suraj or this is Nikhil? I'm not able to.
Nikhil.
Okay.
Sir, Nikhil.
You know, I'm. Yeah. Okay, Nikhil. Thank you, Nikhil.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, guys. So yeah, welcome. So hope to see some of you at least, you know, in the classes. And I think from there on we can try how to, you know, ace anthropology and get some good rank in UPSC, guys. Okay.
Thank you,
okay,
sir.
Okay, guys. Welcome, guys. I'm ending the call. Okay. Okay. Thank you. Bye bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye.